Hello, Gladiators, and welcome back to Keeping Up with the Gardens. As you may already know, a Miami Marlins baseball player, Jose Fernandez, has passed away after a tragic boating accident off the coast of Miami Beach. Jose will not only be remembered by his outstanding baseball career, but also for his enthusiasm and constant inspiration on and off the field.
Come on, let it go. Just let it be. Why don't you be you? And now me. Everything that's broke, leave it to the breeze. Why don't you be you? And I'll be me. And I'll be me. From throwing clothes across the floor, teething calls and slamming doors at you. If this is all we're living for, why are we...
In school news, remember that homecoming tickets are on sale. The last day to purchase them is October 16th on the student portal.
Hurricane Matthew surpassed Miami without doing any harm. Unfortunately, in Haiti, around 900 people were recorded dead. Also, at least 17 died in North Carolina. Please keep them in your prayers.
Are you into sports? Well, then after school, make sure to try out for either girls basketball or boys soccer on October 17th. Don't miss out.
Don't forget, for your up-to-date announcements, you can text HHS Info to 81010 from your mobile device. Data usage may apply.
Become part of the HEHS forensics crew. Come to room 3405 to sign up. Here's a taste of what they do. If you're interested in spending spring break with your friends in Spain, attend the parent meeting on October 13th at 6 p.m. in the auditorium. Well, Gladiators, that's all for today on the Hialeah Gardens News. Now we're going to pass it on to sports.
Tom Bender, Coach Bender. I coach swimming and water polo here at Hialeah Gardens High School. I coach swimming at the middle school. My main job here, though, is the trust counselor, which is basically a mental health counselor of Hialeah Gardens High School. Well, my background in swimming is I swam for a private team since I was the age of 11 for Stingray Swim Club. Kind of cool thing now is I'm coaching against my coaches growing up. Just kind of a neat thing. I have an understanding of what they're going through, especially the private swimmers. If you know anything about swimming, our private swimmers are up at 5 a.m. They're in the water before school. They swim about from 5 to 6:30 in the morning. They come to school, have a whole full academic load. Most of them are in AP and ACE classes. And then they go back to the pool for probably 45 minutes to an hour of either dry land or weight training and another 2 hours in the water, which is a heck of a load, and that's all year long. Swimming's very unique because we're able to have a lot of kids on the team where, you know, a baseball team or a basketball team or a volleyball team, they're very limited about the amount of people they can put on a court or in a baseball field. Just because of the parameters of that sport. With swimming, we can have a lot of people experience what it's like to be on a team. Man, I'm so happy I gave that kid an opportunity because it meant so much to him. I mean, after he graduated, he would come back to practice and always a smile on his face, and still months after he graduated, would come back, "Thanks, coach, thanks for letting me have the opportunity. It was some of my greatest memories." doors open. We drive Coach Ochoa crazy, inviting people out, as many people as we can out on the swim team. We've got 70 people.
It was a pleasure having you here as a guest star, Mr. Bender, and your story is very lovely. Thank you so much for letting us interview you.
Thank you for the opportunity. Go Gladiators.
So yeah, ever since C-Rod hired the word of the day bounty hunter, I mean, people have seeked alternatives to learning the word of the day. So they've come to me after school to get some tattoos. What word are you trying to get?
Diaphanous.
All right, so yeah, diaphanous. That's the eighth time today that I do diaphanous. And we're just gonna go ahead and I don't make much money off this. I only charge them a lab fee. Alright, so let's get this going.
What's up, guys? My name is Angel Lopez. Look at these sweet tattoos I got right here. I got over here Untangible, I got over here Kevin, I have Diaphanous, and over here I got Looney Tunes, man. These are some tattoos right here. Look at them. Let me pose for you right quick. Right there, you see my tricep, my other one, my bicep right here. Look at these and forearms right here. See you later. Slow down a little bit, essay. That's a nice song you got right there. Let me ask you a quick question about the word of the day. What do you think about this word right here, diaphanous? Tell me, right quick, what do you think about it? Stop beating yourself, man. Tell me what you think about the word diaphanous.
Pretty chill, bro.
It's a pretty chill word? What does it mean? How could you not know what diaphanous means, man? It means very sheer and light. Next time I ask you, you better know, essay. You already know?
I already know, bro.
Shawty, let me ask you a quick question right here. You know what the word lutitude means?
It's actually lutitude.
It's the same thing, Shawty. All right, now tell me the definition of lutitude right quick.
It's someone who's opposing to new technology.
Oh, you got it right here, man. Damn. I like you even better, Shawty. I'm gonna go and see my old girl about you. Trying to catch me an essay slip. Catch you slipping, boy!
Yo, man, what's up, bro?
No, you're the one who I got last time.
No, bro.
Tell
no,
me what
no,
Kelvin
no.
stands for. Kelvin!
I don't
Kelvin,
know, man. Something about temperature, bro. I don't know.
Good job.
Hey, Bato, what do you think about Kourtney Kardashian? She looks pretty fine, right?
Sure.
What do you think about Untangible? It looks even better, right? What do you think is the definition for intangible? Better get it right.
I don't know, dude.
You don't know the definition for intangible? It means that it's unfit. Oh, man, you go to the library for nothing? You're a nerd for no reason. I'm out of here. I'm the word of the day essay, and next time I catch one of you boys slipping in the halls without knowing what the word of the day is, you better hope you're gonna see the next word of the day. Remember, this has been your word of the day.
The Weeknd has decided to cut his hair. He did it for his new album Starboy to give it a fresher look to match the feel of the album. Adele reaches milestone with her album 25 going diamond. Her second album to go diamond, but this one took less than a year.
Sorry, there's a family emergency, I have to stop the show.
Reality TV star Kim Kardashian was held at gunpoint this past Sunday, October 2nd, by men dressed as police officers in private mansion.
This past weekend's box office results were Miss Peregrine's Home for Peculiar Children at the top with Deepwater Horizon at second, and The Magnificent Seven at third. Remember to check out the new trailer for the upcoming new Pirates of the Caribbean movie coming 2017.
Garden burger. Steamed carrots. Wednesday. Picadillo. Pizza sticks. Pan con lechon. And brown rice. Thursday. Hamburger. Wings of fire. Chili lime wings. Waffle sweet potatoes. Baked beans. Friday. Primo for cheese pizza. Steamed broccoli. Barbecue pulled pork. And veggie wraps.
Those chili lime wings will be amazing right now.
All folks.
That's my line.
Step aside, babe. Let a star do this. That's all.